Hey everyone, Chrissy here from Spectrum Noir, and today I'm going to show you how to make that card using these color tint pencils along with a cute stamp set and this premium pencil pad. And I will say that that pencil pad, that paper, I have it trimmed down there to 4 by 5 1/4. It is fantastic. It's a little bit thinner paper, but it is worth it because your pencils blend like a dream. They are absolutely fantastic. So the first thing I did was I laid out my stamp set. I am using the Beautiful Bloom stamp set from Crafter's Companion, and I just inked that up with some black ink, and I ended up using a stamping tool here that is definitely not required. You can use any type of acrylic blocks. I just wanted to make sure that I got a perfect impression the first time, which I did. I honestly didn't even need to use my stamping tool, but it's kind of habit for me. And then I just went and I added a cute little sentiment on there. So like I said, this was cut to 4 by 5 1/4, and that is going to fit perfectly on a standard card base that I will show you later. So right now I'm just going to go and I'm going to start coloring. I'm using the color tints, like I mentioned. These colors are so pretty. They are so muted. Currently, there are two sets available. There is the primary and the nature. So for the primary, I used Vintage Rose, which is what I'm using here, Grass Green and Leaf Green for the leaves. And then for the nature set, I used Adobe, and that's kind of like a deep red. And really, I stuck with four colors for this entire card. Because they're colored pencils, I was able to go ahead and color lighter or darker, multiple layers. You know, if you want something darker with the colored pencils and these color tints, you just press harder. So basically what I did is I did everything really lightly my first go around. I just wanted to add some color. And then where I felt that the shadows needed to be, I went in and I colored darker with the same colored pencil. That's the Vintage Rose colored pencil. And I did speed this up a little bit. I'm not superhuman or anything when I color. The great thing about using a stamp set like this, where it already kind of has the shading in there, it makes it easy for you. You don't really have to think about, oh, okay, my light direction's coming from here. Oh, my shadows need to be here, this and that. The stamp set already kind of has it, so really you just go over the darker areas and press harder, add a little bit more pressure, go over it a few more times, and then you just blend it out. So you kind of go heavy to medium to light. But like I said, add that light color base first. So now I'm going in with that Adobe color, like I said, that red color, and I use that for all of the shadows. So like the inner areas of the flower, the areas where the petals are a little bit hidden. And then I went in using the grass green and the leaf green. So same thing, I did everything lightly, and then I came back in with a darker color in those areas that I felt needed to be dark. And then I came back in with that light color again, went over it, and blended them out. If you've never used color pencils before, there is a lot of give with them. Definitely, it does take some practice like anything else. If you're used to alcohol markers or Illustrator markers or anything else like that, sure, there's going to be a little bit of a learning curve. But to be honest with you, colored pencils are very, very easy to use. They are very forgiving. And if you do make a mistake, you can always erase it. So like I said, start out light, add in dark, medium, back to light. And you can see that the whole thing is colored in. So now I'm using this Hessian stock. It is really cool. I cut it perfectly fine with my paper trimmer. And you can see my card base is 4 1/4 by 11. And then I scored it at 5 1/2. I just used my Crafter's Companion tape runner to go ahead and add that, it's like burlap on top of it. And then 3D foam and to give a little bit of dimension on there, because like I mentioned, the premium paper pad is a little bit thinner. So make sure to check out our website, spectrumnoir.com, and follow us on Facebook for all kinds of inspiration. Have a great day.